Oh.
You can really hear this blizzard coming in. Oh yeah. Whoa, you guys hear the wind? Shaking the soup around. It's supposed to blow 60 miles an hour tonight. Oh man, I'm excited. I am starving and this looks really good. I was gonna make rice, but just kind of feel like the gumbo itself. Really hot still, but that's super good. Burning my hand though. This is the first time I made gumbo, and it really wasn't difficult to make. It just took a lot of time and attention. Andrea, one thing, It was definitely worth it. I do feel a little bit guilty because I know you guys have been seeing a whole bunch of cabin building videos or house building videos. And that's just what I've been doing the last half year or so, just been cranking away on that house. So I felt a little bit guilty about not getting enough truck house content for you guys because, number one, I love doing the truck house content. It's fun. I'm out there just living on the road and going on adventures, and it's fun to make the videos and probably more fun for you guys to watch. The reason I made this huge pot of gumbo in the Dutch oven over there is because I want a quick meal while I'm on the road, because I'm about to take you guys on a really epic road trip. We're gonna drive as far north as we can, and I won't tell you all the details yet, but it's gonna be in the darkest week of the year and probably super cold. Hopefully everything goes smooth. So I thought gumbo would be a really hearty meal I could heat up really quick and it would last me all week. I tell you one thing, that is some of the better gumbo I've ever had. I think it's super tasty. Really really good heat to it, really good flavor. And if you guys want a good gumbo recipe, obviously I'm not sponsored or anything by these guys. It's just like on the internet. It's called Favorite Gumbo. If you search for that one, give me some oven, it looks like. But that was super good. Highly recommended. Even though I don't know if I'd make as much as they say, because now I get that much. Oh boy. Starting to pick up a little bit. A little bit pricier than this whole house. It's from like a smaller company, so ooh, yeah, it just looks better. Let's say this is gonna be a win. You guys can't really tell how hard the wind is blowing right now. It's going nuts. You know, I was just here relaxing, and you guys probably have seen the picture of my buddy in the wall, Javier Engel, over there. He's one of my kayaking friends that passed away a long time ago now. It was 2014. He passed away on the Skykomish River in Washington, paddling it when it was pretty high. And miss him a lot. He was young and studying for his doctorates. Even though Javier's focus was to become a doctor, he always made time to go adventure and explore and push and challenge himself and just make memories. And just looking at his little celebration of life card over there, it's, you can see the date he was born and you can see the date he passed away. And I like having that reminder in here because he was one of my best friends. He's like a little brother to me. And it just reminds me of how important time is. Obviously, there's a lot of important things in life. There's family and friends and loved ones and money and careers and getting out and having fun, your health, and just the whole nine yards. But if you don't have time, you don't have any of that stuff. So without time, you have nothing. Therefore, time is the most important thing, in my opinion. I try to put a lot of emphasis in my life on that and try to make the most of my time and try to carve my life out to spend my time doing what I want to be doing. And I think that's a good thing to strive for in life for everybody. It doesn't really matter what you're into particularly. It just matters that you carve out your time and delegate your time and choose your time wisely to provide you with as much time as you can get for what you want to do in your life. So I just saw his picture over there again and was just thinking about that. I thought I'd share that with you guys. Anyway, I think these cookies are done. I'm going to pull them out here and we're gonna watch a movie. After the movie, I'm gonna go to bed pretty early because I need to wake up really early and make sure we're not stuck in 3 or 4 feet of snow out there. If we are, I'm gonna have to get the snowblower off of the truck bed trailer potentially and plow out this pullout so I can even get out of here. And then we're gonna go drive about 2,000 miles. So that's the plan. Whew, it's getting deep. I just came out to check on it. It is crazy out here. The wind is ripping right now. Those are good. These cookies smell so good. Get some of this to go with the cookies. These are pretty cool. This is a 12 volt TV. So it's powered off a car battery essentially and uses really low power actually. But it also has a DVD player on it. So this is one of my favorite movies. I don't know why. I've just always liked it. Oh man, you can't beat this. Got some fresh cookies, eggnog, and a movie. I feel like that's my life. I've got my alarm set for 5 a.m. I believe, so I'm gonna go ahead and pass out and I'll see you guys in the morning, see what it looks like. I'm a little bit nervous. I just walked outside a second ago and the wind's blowing really hard, so the snow doesn't look deep right beside the camper, but up in front of it is super drifted in. It's already a couple feet deep, so we'll see. I might be getting out the snowblower in the morning to get out of here. Anyway, I'm gonna make this bed and catch you guys in the morning. about 4 o'clock in the morning. My alarm just went off. I wanted to wake up early because I've got a feeling there's going to be a lot of snow drifted up outside, which means I'm going to have to drive the snowblower off of the truck bed trailer and see if I can't plow some of the snow out of the way so I can get the truck out of this parking spot. Otherwise, I'm going to totally be stuck. So I'm going to do that, get the truck out of here, and then we have a 2,000-mile drive to the top of Alaska, to the Arctic Ocean, in this old truck on the darkest week of the year. Probably one of the coldest ones, too, so here we go. Nice dry mucklucks. I like hanging them up overnight, so they're nice and dry. I had a bunch of you guys asking about these mucklucks. These are made by a company called Steger Mucklucks in Minnesota. And they are the most comfortable and warm winter boots you will ever own. I'm not sponsored by these guys. I bought a couple pairs of these. Been wearing them about 12 years now. This is my second pair. I've had these about 8 years. And yeah, they're just awesome. And the cool part is you can roll them up really high and tie them off around your knees and then walk through deep snow. Probably like I'm about to do in a second here. I just turned the diesel heater on this morning to warm it up really quick, take the edge off, so it's nice and toasty in here, but out into the cold we go, here we go. Oh boy, see what we're dealing with. First thing we're gonna do is start this diesel and get it warm here. It's been a good truck, man. This thing always starts, no matter how freaking cold, down to like negative 25. All right, girl, let's do it. Oh yeah, fired right up. Awesome. Oh yeah, look at that snow. We're gonna have to get the snowblower out. There's not that much in the truck because it's blowing so hard all night, but it's not that deep here, but it's all drifted up. Doesn't look like a ton of snow, but you can see it's all drifted up, blocking the entrance over there. Here goes nothing. I should have filmed that. There was a car that was broken down. You guys might have seen it in the background, and he'd been stuck there a couple days, and his buddy just showed up there here at like 4:30 in the morning, and just both of them got super stuck. So I just drove the snowblower out that way, and it's not deep here, but it's just really deep right where the road is, where it drifted, but we just got them out. And now I got a 2,000 mile drive. Here we go. Hopefully we can get out of here. I think we can. Look at this Mack truck stuck, dude. Literally in the middle of the highway. That's bad news. Holy crap. Well, thanks for watching, y'all. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. I've got a bunch of adventures coming up. New video every week, so see you on the road.